Today on this Growth Point video, I want to take a moment and speak to you about seasons of trials in ministry. A friend of mine said to me years ago, "It is impossible to follow Jesus without hurts." And little did I know how prophetic that particular statement would be. There's going to be difficulties. In fact, the Bible predicts that in the world we will have tribulations. But Jesus said, "Be of good cheer, I have overcome the world." I don't know, as I speak today, if you're going through a period of trials and difficulties in your life or in your ministry, but I just thought I'd talk with you for a few minutes today about some of the causes and some of the solutions that God gives us to those heavy seasons in ministry. You know, oftentimes, if we're just honest and if we step back and think about the trials in ministry, we need to remember that we have opposition from an enemy that absolutely hates the cross of Jesus Christ and everyone that preaches the cross of Jesus Christ. And so spiritual opposition is very evident in a soul-winning ministry. The Bible says we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. In Luke 23:10, the Bible says, "The chief priest and the scribe stood and vehemently accused Jesus." If the Lord Jesus experienced that, why do we become filled with the idea that we don't deserve it, or why is it happening to us? And the fact is that it's something like a football player going to a football game and expecting to never be hit. That's just not going to happen. And spiritual opposition is going to come. Those that are living a godly life in Christ Jesus will suffer. And so just remember today that we're in a spiritual battle, and sometimes that's the reason for the trials. Sometimes trials can come into our lives and into our ministries because of mistakes that we have made, things that we have done that looking back we would have done differently. The fact is that we may have said something we wish we wouldn't have said. We may have allowed something to take place in ministry that we would have done differently. There may have been a spirit that you had that in retrospect was not the fruit of the Spirit. And when those issues are self-inflicted, normally the sooner we admit that, the better we are. The better we'll be perhaps making reconciliation with others and moving on as a learning experience. Someone said, "Peace is not found in the absence of trouble. It is found in the presence of God." And those trials oftentimes drive us to the presence of God in ways that otherwise we would not have gone. And then thirdly, I think sometimes in today's ministry landscape, some of the difficulties that pastors will face will be born out of a spirit of jealousy from others in the ministry. I once heard a man by the name of Bob Smith say, "All you have to do to make some Christians angry with you is to become a failure or a success. When you know more, do more, or have more, people hate you. The Christian world is looking for leaders who are brilliantly mediocre." And you'll find that when you're just kind of plodding along and not a lot is happening, no one really even notices. But sometimes when things are moving along and God is blessing, people will put a spin on that sometimes can be difficult. And just realize that that's a part of the ministry landscape oftentimes in today's environment as well. And it exists in many different groups, movements, and camps as well. I think a fourth reason that we experience trials and difficulties in life is because we minister in a corrupt culture. It's often amazing to me some of the different mail and responses that I'll receive just for preaching the Bible, sometimes from people that are a part of the gay agenda, people that have viewpoints that are basically anti-God or Bible on a variety of subjects. And the Bible says in 2 Timothy 3 that in the last times, perilous times will come. Men will be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, blasphemers, etc., etc. That passage, while we don't have time to study it, is truly definitive of the moments in which we live. And we need to remember that trials often come because we're living in those last days and because of the corruption of our culture. So what are some of the things that you and that I can do today to respond properly when the seasons of trials come? First of all, we need to focus on the Lord or refocus on the Lord. The Bible is very clear that that we're to be looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Someone said, treat criticism like bubble gum. You chew on it a little while, and then you spit it out. And so don't dwell incessantly on it. Learn what you can, refocus on the Lord, and go forward. Secondly, remember that God is always in control. Rest in the umbrella of His sovereignty for your own life. Remember that pain in the present, like everything else, is constantly changing. It's going to come, it's going to go, but keep your focus on the Lord and remember that God is in control of these seasons. Thirdly, let me encourage you, hear the voice of God. God wants to speak to you during those trials. Hear His still, small voice. Peace is not found in the absence of trouble. It's found in the presence of God. Matthew 5:11, blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you, and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. And then finally, when those seasons of trials come, always remember not to respond in the flesh, not to be filled with self-pity or anger, but to seek a new endowment of the Holy Spirit, to walk in the Spirit. I think about Elizabeth Elliot, who went back into the Andes to witness to the man who had killed her husband, truly responding in the right way to the trials of her life. And God will allow these trials, but remember that all of the fiery trials are Father-filtered. And it's my prayer that God will give you grace today. And let's pray for one another as we serve the Lord in these trying times, that we can live the abundant life by the grace of God during these times.